Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video I'll show you how to work with appointments in Blazor Scheduler. Now, let me proceed to show you how to make specific appointments AllDay and recurring events. And how to make the appointments read-only, as well as how to block specific time slots. Also, few additional items like how to enable tooltip for the appointments and how to change the title of the field labels in the editor window. As we have already seen, how to create and configure the Blazor application, as well as how to add the Blazor scheduler with simple list data. So, you can refer to the Getting Started video to know the steps, and you can also find its reference link in the above YouTube card. Now, I'm directly going to continue with the existing application. Here, I have bound simple event list data to the Blazor scheduler with the fields ID, subject, start time, and end time. Along with this, I also defined tValue property with appropriate value to specify the scheduler data source type. Now let me run this application to show you the output of this example. So here, you can view the scheduler with the event appointments. In this scheduler, you can see the appointments are defined with a particular time slot. Suppose, if I want to make the appointment as an all-day event. Then, I may need to use the isAllDay property of the scheduler component. Now, I'm going to make the testing appointment as an all-day event. Therefore, first let me define a bool property isAllDay inside the appointment data model class. And then, I will set the value as true for isAllDay property. Look at the scheduler component now, you can see the testing appointment at the top section near the date header. Sometimes, you may want to repeat the appointments for a specific period. In this case, you can use the recurrence rule property with some valid rule string. Here, I've planned to repeat this scrum meeting appointment for 10 more days. So, first I need to define the recurrence rule property within this appointment data model class. Then, for recurrence rule property, I'll set the frequency as daily, interval as 1. And count as 10 inside the scrum meeting appointment data so that this appointment will repeat on a daily basis for 10 occurrences. You can view the changes over here where the appointments are repeated for 10 more days in the scheduler. Here, by default, the edit and delete options are enabled for these appointments. Suppose if I want to make these appointments read-only, then I may need to disable those edit and delete options. To disable edit and delete options, I need to define the read-only property and set its value as true within the schedule tag. So now, the edit and delete options are disabled for the appointments, and you cannot perform any CRUD operations on these appointments. Alright, now let me show you how to block a specific time range on the scheduler with the help of blocked events. To block the specific time range, first, I need to define the property isBlock within this appointment data model class. Here, I'm going to block the time range for the demo meeting appointment. So, let me add the isBlock property and set its value as true inside this data list item. Look at the scheduler now, where the demo meeting appointment created for specific time interval blocks the time range on the scheduler. Next, let me proceed to show you how to enable a tooltip for the appointments. To enable tooltip within the schedule tag, let me define the property enable tooltip and set its value as true. And now, while hovering the scheduler appointment, the appointment details are shown. Now, I'll show you how to change the title of field labels in the editor window. To change the default field labels, first, I need to define schedule field tag. Here, I'm going to change the following field labels text, such as subject, location, description, start time, and end time. So, let me define the tags field subject, field location, field description, field start time, and field end time. Then, I'll define the property title and set appropriate values for it. Along with this, I also need to remove read-only property, as I'm going to perform CRUD operations. Look at the scheduler now, the editor window displayed with new field labels such as event, event location, comments, event start time, and event end time. Apart from these appointment options, you can also perform many more options on the scheduler appointments. So now, let me proceed to show you those appointment options. You can easily perform CRUD operations with any kind of appointment on the scheduler using Data Manager. That is, you can easily create, read, update, and delete the appointments as and when required from the scheduler using the Data Manager. The Data Manager is a component offered by Syncfusion to support such CRUD data manipulations. Other than the normal CRUD action, you can also select and delete multiple events at a time. Select multiple appointments all at once by holding the Control key and then simultaneously click on the events that you want to delete and press the Delete key. You can now delete the multiple events all at once. And you can easily extend a scheduler event's time by resizing either its start or end handlers. The next thing is the event customization, which is made much simplified with the template option. If you want to know more about working with scheduler appointments, then you can refer to the documentation page, which I have shared in the description part. Okay, now let me make a quick summary of what we have seen so far. We have seen how to make the appointment as an all-day and recurrence event. Also, we have seen how to block the specific time slots and how to make the specific events read-only on the Blazor scheduler. Finally, we have also seen how to enable a tooltip for the appointments and how to change the title of field labels in the editor window. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link, which is shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting a free license key to use our complete Blazor products if you fit into our community guidelines. So check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using our community license. Also, if you find this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.